Of being numerous, also a series, a serial poem. There are things we live among, and to see them is to know ourselves, a currents, a part of an infinite series, the sad marvels. Of this was told a tale of our wickedness. It is not our wickedness. You remember that old town we went to when we sat in the ruined window and we tried to imagine that we belonged to those times? It is dead and it is not dead, and you cannot imagine either its life or its death. The earth speaks and the salamander speaks. The spring comes and only obscures it. So spoke of the existence of things, an unmanageable pantheon, absolute, but they say, arid. City of the corporations, glassed in dreams and images. And the pure joy of the mineral fact, though it is impenetrable as the world, if it is matter, is impenetrable. The emotions are engaged, entering the city, as entering any city. We are not coeval with the locality, but we imagine others are. We encounter them. Actually, a populace flows through the city. This is a language, therefore, of New York. For the people of that flow are new, the old, new to age as the young, to youth and to their dwelling, for which the tarred roofs and the stoops and doors, a world of stoops, our petty alibi and satirical wit will not serve. The great stone above the river, in the pylon of the bridge, 1875, frozen in the moonlight, in the frozen air over the footpath, consciousness, which has nothing to gain, which awaits nothing, which loves itself. We are pressed on each other. We will be told at once of anything that happens, and the discovery of fact bursts in a paroxysm of emotion, now as always. Crusoe, we say, was rescued, so we have chosen. Obsessed, bewildered by the shipwreck of the singular, we have chosen the meaning of being numerous. Amor fati, the love of fate, for which the city alone is audience, perhaps blasphemous. Slowly over islands, destinies moving steadily pass and change in the thin sky over islands, among days, having only the force of days, most simple, most difficult. Whether, as the intensity of seeing increases, one's distance from them, the people, does not also increase. I know, of course I know, I can enter no other place. Yet I am one of those who from nothing but man's way of thought and one of his dialects and what has happened to me have made poetry. To dream of that beach for the sake of an instant in the eyes, the absolute singular, the unearthly bonds of the singular, which is the bright light of shipwreck. Or in that light, new arts, dithyrambic, audience as artists, but I will listen to a man, I will listen to a man, and when I speak, I will speak, though he will fail and I will fail, but I will listen to him speak. The shuffling of a crowd is nothing, well, nothing but the many that we are, but nothing. Urban art, art of the cities, art of the young in the cities. The isolated man is dead, his world around him exhausted. And he fails, that meditative man, and indeed they cannot bear it. It is that light seeps anywhere, a light for the times, in which the buildings stand on low ground, their pediments just above the harbor, absolutely immobile. Hollow, available, you could enter any building, you could look from any window. One might wave to himself from the top of the Empire State Building. Speak, if you can. Speak, Phyllis, not neoclassic. The girl's name is Phyllis. Coming home from her first job on the bus in the bare civic interior, among those people, the small doors opening on the night at the curb. Her heart, she told me, suddenly tight with happiness. So small a picture, a spot of light on the curb, it cannot demean us. I too am in love down there with the streets and the square slabs of pavement. To talk of the house and the neighborhood and the docks, and it is not art. In these explanations, it is presumed that an experiencing subject is one occasion of a sensitive reaction to an actual world. The rain falls that had not been falling, and it is the same world. They made small objects of wood and the bones of fish and of stone. They talked, families talked, they gathered in council and spoke, carrying objects. They were credulous, their things shone in the forest. They were patient with the world. This will never return, never, unless having reached their limits, they will begin over, that is, over and over. Unable to begin, at the beginning the fortunate find everything already here. They are shoppers, choosers, judges, and here the brutal is without issue, a dead end. They develop argument in order to speak. They become unreal, unreal. Life loses solidity, loses extent. Baseball's their game, because baseball is not a game, but an argument and difference of opinion makes the horse races. They are ghosts that endanger one soul. There is change in an air that smells stale. They will come to the end of an era, first of all peoples, and one may honorably keep his distance if he can. I cannot even now altogether disengage myself from those men with whom I stood in emplacements, in mess tents, in hospitals and sheds, and hid in the gullies of blasted roads in a ruined country, among the many men more capable than I. Micah and a sergeant named Healy, that lieutenant also. How forget that? How talk distantly of the people who are that force within the walls of cities, wherein their cars echo like history down walled avenues in which one cannot speak. Chorus, androgynous, find me so that I will exist. Find my navel so that it will exist. Find my nipples so that they will exist. Find every hair of my belly. I am good or I am bad. Find me. He who will not work shall not eat. And only he who is troubled shall find rest. And only he who descends into the nether world shall rescue his beloved. And only he who unsheathes his knife shall be given Isaac again. He who will not work shall not eat, but he who will work shall give birth to his own father. The roots of words dim in the subways. There is madness in the number of the living, a state of matter. There is nobody here but us chickens. Anti-ontology, he wants to say, his life is real. No one can say why. It is not easy to speak. A ferocious mumbling in public of rootless speech. It is the air of atrocity, an event as ordinary as a president. A plume of smoke visible at a distance in which people burn. Now in the helicopters, the casual will is atrocious. Insanity in high places. If it is true we must do these things, we must cut our throats. The fly in the bottle, insane, the insane fly, which over the city is the bright light of shipwreck. They await War in the news is war, as always, that the juices may flow in them, though the juices lie. Great things have happened on the earth and given it history, armies and the ragged hordes moving and the passions of that death. But who escapes death among these riders of the subway? They know, by now as I know, failure and the guilt of failure. As in Hardy's poem of Christmas, we might half hope to find the animals in the sheds of a nation kneeling at midnight. Farm animals, draft animals, beasts for slaughter, because it would mean they have forgiven us, or, which is the same thing, that we do not altogether matter. They can be a brick in a brick wall, the eye picks, so quiet of a Sunday. Here is the brick, it was waiting, here when you were born, Marianne. Clarity. In the sense of transparence. I don't mean that much can be explained. Clarity in the sense of silence. Half free and half mad, and the jet set is in. The vocabularies of the 40s gave way to the jet stream and the media, the Mustang and the deals, and the people will change again. Under the soil, in the blind pressure, the lump, entity of substance changes also. In 24 rooms, 24 apartments, after the party, the girls stare at the ceilings blindly as they are filled, and then they sleep. In this nation, which is in some sense our home, covenant, the covenant is, there shall be peoples. Strange that the youngest people I know live in the oldest buildings, scattered about the city in the dark rooms of the past and the immigrants, the black rectangular buildings of the immigrants. They are the children of the middle class, the pure products of America, investing, the ancient buildings jostle each other, in the half-forgotten, that ponderous business, this Chinese war. They carry nativeness to a conclusion in suicide. We want to defend limitation and do not know how. Stupid to say merely that poets should not lead their lives among poets. They have lost the metaphysical sense of the future. They feel themselves the end of a chain of lives, single lives, and we know that lives are single and cannot defend the metaphysic on which rest the boundaries of our distances. We want to say common sense and cannot. We stand on that denial of death that paved the cities, generation for generation, and the pavement is filthy as the corridors of the police. How shall one know a generation, a new generation? Not by the dew on them, where the earth is most torn and the wounds untended and the voices confused. There is the head of the moving column, who, if they cannot find their generation, wither in the infirmaries and the supply depots supplying irrelevant objects. Street lamps shine on the parked cars steadily in the clear night. It is true the great mineral silence vibrates, hums a process completing itself, in which the windshield wipers of the cars are visible. The power of the mind, the power and weight of the mind, which is not enough, it is nothing and does nothing against the natural world, behemoth, white whale, beast, they will say, and less than beast, the fatal rock, which is the world. Oh, if the streets seem bright enough, fold within fold, of residence, or see through water, clearly the pebbles of the beach through the water flowing from the ripple, clear as ever they have been. It is difficult now to speak of poetry, about those who have recognized the range of choice or those who have lived within the life they were born to. It is not precisely a question of profundity, but of a different order of experience. One would have to tell what happens in a life, what choices present themselves, what the world is for us, what happens in time, what thought is in the course of a life, and therefore what art is in the isolation of the actual. I would want to talk of rooms and of what they look out on, and of basements, the rough walls bearing the marks of the forms, the old marks of wood in the concrete, such solitude as we know, and the swept floors. Someone, a workman, bearing about him, feeling about him that peculiar word like a dishonored fatherhood, has swept this solitary floor, this profoundly hidden floor, such solitude as we know. One must not come to feel that he has a thousand threads in his hands. He must somehow see the one thing. This is the level of art. There are other levels, but there is no other level of art. The light of the closed pages, tightly closed, packed against each other, exposes the new day, the narrow, frightening light before a sunrise. my daughter, what can I say of living? I cannot judge it. We seem caught in reality together, my lovely daughter. I have a daughter, but no child. And it was not precisely happiness we promised ourselves. We say happiness. Happiness and are not satisfied. Though the house on the lowland of the city catches the dawn light, I can tell myself, and I tell myself, only what we all believe true. And in the sudden vacuum of time, is it not in fear the roots grip downward and beget the baffling hierarchies of father and child, as of leaves and their high, thin twigs to shield us from time, from open time. Behind their house, behind the back porch, are the little woods. She walks into them sometimes and awaits the birds and the deer. Looking up, she sees the blue, bright sky above the branches. If one had been born here, how could one believe it? Because the known and the unknown touch, one witnesses. It is ennobling, if one thinks so. If to know is noble, it is ennobling. Only that it should be beautiful. Only that it should be beautiful. Oh, beautiful. Red, green, blue, the wet lips, laughing, or the curl of the white shell, and the beauty of the women, the perfect tendons under the skin, the perfect life that can twist in a flood of desire, not truth but each other, the bright, bright skin, her hands wavering in her incredible need. Which is ours, which is ourselves, this is our jubilation. Exalted and as old as that truthfulness which illumines speech. Like the wind in the trees and the bells of the procession, how light the air is and the earth, children and the grass and the wind and the voices of men and women to be carried about the sun forever, among the beautiful particulars of the breezes, the papers blown about the sidewalks. A female will to hide the most evident God under a covert? Surely infiniteness is the most evident thing in the world. Is it the courage of women to assume every burden of blindness themselves? Intruders carrying life, the young women carrying life unaided in their arms in the streets, weakened by too much need of too little, and life seeming to depend on women, burdened and desperate as they are. Or define man beyond rescue of the impoverished, solve whole cities before we can face again forests and prairies. Though the world is the obvious, the seen, and unforeseeable, that which one cannot not see, which the first eyes saw for us, also each man or woman near is knowledge, though it may be of the noon's own vacuity. And the mad too speak only of conspiracy and people talking, and if those paths of the mind cannot break, it is not the wild glare of the world even that one dies in. Approach the window as if to see the boredom which disclosed everything. I should have written not the rain of a 19th century day, but the motes in the air, the dust here still. What have we argued about? What have we done? Thickening the air? Air so thick with myth, the words unlucky and good luck float in it? To see them? No. Or seize motes, an iron mesh, links of consequence, still at the mind's end, relevant. You are the last who will know him, nurse. Not know him. He is an old man, a patient. How could one know him? You are the last who will see him or touch him, nurse. Occurring neither for self nor for truth, the sad marvels, in the least credible circumstance, storm or bombardment, or the room of a very old man. Whitman, April 19th, 1864. The capital grows upon one in time, especially as they've got the great figure on top of it now, and you can see it very well. It is a great bronze figure, the genius of liberty, I suppose. It looks wonderful toward sundown. I love to go and look at it. The sun, when it is nearly down, shines on the headpiece, and it dazzles and glistens like a big star. It looks quite curious.